So although I really enjoyed pushing back the frontiers in science and doing basic science research, I was more interested or passionate about seeing those scientific breakthroughs or discoveries translate into actual commercial products, be they drugs, vaccines, other therapeutics, or pharmaceuticals. That was kind of interesting. So I actually never submitted an application. A postdoc that I had worked with previously, he spoke with the hiring manager at his current company and they had a position open. So I was actually recruited into the position, my first position. So I didn't put out any cover letters and submit resumes or an application. They actually came and sought me out. So there's a lot of variety in my current position. I have to interact with clients. So sometimes I will conduct actual face-to-face meetings where we're discussing development reports and the progress of their work, the projects that we're doing. And then where I work, it's a contract development and manufacturing organization. So essentially, we try to really bridge the gap between academic discoveries and actual commercialization of products. So there's times when I'm in the laboratory actually performing experiments, so exercising my technical skill set that I learned here at Hopkins. And then there's other times when I'm just drafting documentation and having to use some of those soft skills. So I think it's really important to think about what transferable skills that you have here and start thinking about what your niche is. If you really enjoy writing things, then perhaps you might be successful as a technical writer. That's a large part of what I do, just drafting documentation so that people can adequately see the development and the work that's been done. So the one skill I think that you need to possess, regardless of the job that you're applying for, you need to have good communication skills, both oral and written. For most of these positions, you're going to have to interface with a variety of different people. They could be subject matter experts, they could be physicians, they could be stakeholders, they could be venture capitalists. So you need to be able to communicate to a variety of different audiences. In addition to that, you also need to have good written communication skills. You need to be able to draft documents that clearly articulate the views or the points that you're trying to express or relay. In addition to that, depending on what the position actually is, if you look at the duties or the responsibilities that they expect you to perform, that will often clue you in to the skill set that they expect you to have. So for instance, if you're looking at a job announcement that says that they expect you to have good chromatography skills or great separation techniques, then that's something that you should have. But I think that will be specific to the position or the job that you're looking at. It just depends on what your niche is and what you feel most comfortable doing. But quite often, if you look at the keywords listed there, that'll give you a clue as to what you need to demonstrate to them. Because although you might not have a degree in project management, if you had to juggle several different dissertation projects while you were here, then you have some experience with project management. So just trying to think of your transferable skills that could be applicable in a variety of different positions. So one of the myths that I was told about industry was that you wouldn't have the opportunity to be creative. Every day in my position, I have to be creative. I have to come up with innovative approaches, methodologies, ways of doing things that require me to think outside of the box. So this position hasn't hampered my creativity in any way. And I have great flexibility in terms of what I do.